to 99 employees. However, 34% of all the jobs in Northeast Florida are supplied by the stage two businesses. So 8% of all the businesses supply 34% of all the jobs. So what our main focus is, we've got to get more people thinking about what does it take for me to become a second stage business. Now, if we don't make it, let's say instead of 10 employees, you have 7. Let's say you don't make it to 10 million, you only make it to 4. Is there anybody in the room who would not want to have a $4 million gross revenue a year business
I'm gonna make sure you're not gonna
with
get that
at least 7
money.
Employees? Is there anybody that doesn't want that? Everybody wants that, okay? Now, if everyone in the room had at least 7 employees and was generating $4 million in revenues, I can tell you whoever's in charge of economic development, whoever's the head at the city, would be extremely happy because what you're doing is you're really generating energy around your local economy. And the last piece is how many of you are doing more business outside of Flagler County than you are inside? Show of hands. Okay? Right now, I'm involved with a project with UCF. It's called Grow Florida. Our main focus is to find businesses that are generating at least 50% or more of their revenues outside of the region that they're in. Why is that important? Because if all of you are generating 50% or more of your revenues outside of your region and you're headquartered here, where are you spending most of your money? Right here. Okay, so sometimes we take a look at our business and we say, oh, I can't get as much business here locally. Really what we need is you getting as much business outside of your region and bringing the cash inflows back to your community so you can hire people and impact your local community. And so my job at the Jacks Chamber, number one, is to have a regional focus. Again, I would not be here without Kai. And again, I'd just like for everybody to give him a big round of applause. A lot of times we look at larger organizations to be the champion of entrepreneurship, but we really need individual champions like Kai, and there's a lot of others that I've met here tonight to be the champions. The larger organizations, we may have the programs, we may have the different resources, but we can't get them out to the individual entrepreneurs like you without people like Kai and having events like this. So my main message to you would be, number one, try to think about your business from a regional perspective. So even though you're here in Flagler, how much business can I do in different counties? How much business can I do in another state? What's my radius for doing business? So if you drew a, let's say, 90-mile radius from Flagler, how far could you go to do business? Second, what's your distribution channels? So a lot of us as small business owners, we don't really think about how our resources get to us and how we take our individual products and services to different customers. If we really think about that process, we have an opportunity to expand the amount of business that we can do. And then third, in terms of your entrepreneurial support organizations, how many people are here? I know at least one person is here who's an entrepreneurial support organization. How many support organizations do we have here tonight?
All of them are here.
Okay. If there's any advice I can give you as individual entrepreneurs and Kai, get as many entrepreneur support organizations at these type of events. There are so many times we have opportunities to train people on entrepreneurship, but you guys aren't coming. You guys are not going to those events. You're coming here, and I would too, I mean, if I get a drink ticket. But, and maybe that's what we need to do with the training events. But most of you are going to be here, and this is where it starts. And so, again, I could talk forever about entrepreneurship. I'm all about helping businesses and entrepreneurs. But most importantly, I want to give a big thanks to Kai. He drove to Jacksonville to meet with me. And I was supposed to be at the last event, but I had something come up at the last minute. But he and I have committed to actually working together. We don't know what that's going to look like, okay? But we know that there's a commitment between the two of us to have some type of regional impact here in Flagler County. And again, I want to thank each and every one of you for allowing me to come down and to speak with you for a few minutes. And I'm going to leave with one thing. Each one of you has an opportunity next year, and I don't know what your business is, but you have an opportunity next year to be one of the companies to watch in the state of Florida. So UCF has this great program where they recognize 50 companies to watch every single year. Doesn't matter what you did this year. It's about what you're capable of. And we have 50 companies which we all traveled to Orlando, and they were recognized as one of the 50 companies to watch in regards to growth. Some of them were technology, some of them were services, some of them had traditional products, some of them were manufacturing. But what I would like for each and every one of you to consider, if you're going to start a business, if you're going to grow a business, is there anybody in the house that is not interested in growing their business? So you're all growth companies. If you're a growth company, you really need to focus on where I want to be. Do I want to be a company to watch? Do I want to be a second stage company and impact my community? If you're one of those, you will be highly recognized, not only in Flagler, but throughout the state of Florida. And I'll end with that, and again, I want to say thank you guys for allowing me to come and be a part of Entrepreneurs Night Out. I'll be back, and I look forward to working with Kai and some of the other people in the audience. Thank you so much.